Hello friends, hope you're well. Techman Pat here. Today we are reviewing these, the Razer Hammerhead X True Wireless Earbuds. This, my friends, is something I was not expecting out of Razer. But after all, you know what? It is expected. Razer has been doing a lot of crazy, cool, gamery stuff. Why not earbuds, right? Well, stay tuned for the review. Make sure to like this video if you did, and subscribe if you want to support us. Let's roll the intro. The first thing you have to know about this is that when you wear them, you're going to be lit up green with the Razer logo. There is a sticker on these that literally says green backlit Razer logo. Okay, thanks. I mean, I was really looking for that. But if you're a Razer fan, why not have a backlit Razer logo? The box is small and it comes with this little pill box. The pill box itself is pretty weird feeling. Before we get into the headphones, I do want to point this out. It's a matte. I don't know if it's metallic. I tried magnets, I wasn't sure if there's battery in there or whatnot, but it feels matte, it feels really thin. It's not like the premium feeling one that you get for, let's say, the Apple AirPods Pro, but I would say that for Razer, this feels fantastic and it certainly feels much better than a lot of other premium true wireless earbuds. In this case, it is USB-C. You can plug in really easily. Obviously, it's reversible. Love USB-C. And inside, we get two rather massive earbuds. And that's the first thing you'll notice. They are not small at all. They are quite large, and that is itself its first downfall. First of all, it has no rubber grommets around it. It's more like the traditional AirPods from Apple, where it's just a plastic ear thing that goes inside. It does come with some rubber grommets you can put around just in case it doesn't fit quite well. But, you know, it should fit most actual ears. And I would say that if Apple can do it, why not Razer? I always called Razer the Apple of gaming products, and I still think this kind of proves it. First of all, they fit pretty well in my ears. I will have to use the rubber grommets if I'm going for a run, however, because they tend to fall out. Maybe it's because I'm a little bit tubby on the chin and doesn't quite push in, and the plastic is also very smooth. And every time you push in, there is touch sensitive buttons on the sides where the logo actually is. But it also means that if I just want to quickly push it in, I'm also tapping and starting things. Music might stop, it might skip, it might go to the next track. And the problem is, it's touch directional, which means you can sort of swipe to the left or sort of go to the right and it should do something, but I can never tell what I'm doing because it's kind of hard to navigate from the ear, from the side, and it's not particularly sensitive. I found the sensitivity to be odd at best. And lastly, when I take it out, music doesn't stop. It doesn't have the sensor, or maybe I haven't been able to turn it on to tell when it's actually in your ears. So if you're used to going, good to meet you, it'll still keep playing in your other ear and in both. You put it down, it'll still keep playing, and that's a little bit frustrating. But apart from those frustrations and the fact that they're kind of hard to handle and put into the box, maybe I'm just dyslexic about it, but I find it kind of hard. It has a satisfying click, so that's a bonus. But I really want to talk about the positives and why it is actually worth $70 and $184. Yes, it is peculiarly expensive. The sound quality on these beats out any AirPods you have in your drawer right now. I cannot believe how good they are. They sound absolutely fantastic. Any music type I threw at it, it sounded perfectly for highs, lows, and mids. I realize why the size is the size, because it's got some pretty epic drivers in there. I also found that the music control through the app was really good and I could maintain a bit of control, but I really didn't need to. There was no need for me to maintain that control. I didn't need it because out of the box, the default settings sounded absolutely fantastic. It worked with my Apple phone and the connection to the Bluetooth was absolutely seamless. And as soon as I take these out of the box, it connects straight away. Some people say that when you have an Apple phone and you get non-Apple earbuds, you have problems with connections. I did not, and I'm very impressed. That is probably why, if you do have an Apple device and you're looking for some earbuds, I could recommend these to you, no problem at all. compared to other products out there from the Android ecosystem. What else can be said about these earphones? Well, I wouldn't go running with them, but I would definitely sit on a bus or a train listening to them, unless I obviously had the little rubber grommets that it does come with. And I do feel that they are pretty light, light enough to be in my ears. Now, for the microphone test, here is me
basically recording a memo of what I'm saying right now. I think at the end of the day, they sound pretty good on the microphone. I got to have a few phone calls with people and nobody complained. Not that they would, but I did ask my wife, hey, does it sound okay? She said, yeah, it sounds fine. Why? What's going on? I'm like, well, no, don't worry, it's fine. I'm just testing some earbuds out. Nonetheless, you can be the judge of the quality of this, especially when I bring them back
to this microphone right here, which isn't particularly the best microphone out there, so the comparison might be skewed, but at least you know what it sounds like. These are not active cancellation headphones, but again, that's why the price is as much as it is. But they are very low latency at 60 milliseconds. This means you can play video games on your mobile device. Not that Razer is really kind of the company you'd be buying from if you're playing mobile games, but nonetheless you can. But it also means that if you're typing away and chatting away on Messenger or MSN, of what the kids do these days, you will not have that weird delay with some headphones that when you press a button and it clicks after the fact, it sounds really weird. And it also means that video calls and, of course, any that requires an actual sync to your lips will work really, really well. These also work with Windows. I did test it out for a Skype call once. I was really bored and I thought I'd plug them in, and it worked really, really well with Windows Bluetooth. So these are very great earbuds, and I would highly recommend them to anyone who does not want to use Apple's own and might have an Apple device or an Android device. These are certainly contenders in the ecosystem. And right now I could really say that, hey, if you've got Razer already, you will not be disappointed with these. Friends, thank you very much for watching. Make sure to like this video if you did. Big thanks to Razer for sending me these for review. I couldn't believe the build quality, the mobile app that let me control all these things. Really, really good. It's an interesting ecosystem to the point where you go, these guys know exactly what they're doing. I'm looking forward to the more iterations, one with noise cancellations and things like that. Thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you all in another one. Bye.